Hello, coffee drinkers. So excited to present Chordal Harmony Volume 2. We have 40 brand new exercises, and there are links below this video. Of course, to the physical copies, you can get physical copies at Amazon. They ship worldwide, and of course, you can get the digital copy right away. Also link below at my website that comes with the video and the book all bundled together digitally. If you are getting a physical copy and you want the video companion to go with it, there is a page inside telling you exactly where you need to go to get that video. And also something that I put way more time and energy into this time was the video companion for the book. It's like a digital DVD to download, and it's 2.25 hours long. Now, let's get to the lesson. 40 brand new exercises. We're gonna be looking at a couple of them today to highlight the differences between playing chords on a 4-string bass and on a 5-string bass. I wanna say that for anyone who's not familiar with this bass or with my playing, that this is a 5-string bass but strung E to C. So I'm absolutely able to play a lot of things in the standard 4-string range, and I will do my best to stay in that range, that 21 fret kind of E natural, 20th fret E flat range of a standard 4-string P bass or Fender bass of some sort. Let's take a look at this first exercise that you heard at the very beginning of the video. This is a lot to do with inner moving parts. It's also to do with voice leading and with chord melody, all rolled into one exercise. And I'm playing it in the range of a standard 4-string bass. I do also want to make the example of how much brighter that is and how much more those parts sing out when you play it in the range of a 5-string bass with a high C. I think it's fairly safe to say that if I can play you the example with a standard 4-string tuning, anyone out there with a bass strung, 5-string bass strung with a low B can also do that. But as soon as you start getting down below kind of B flat on the E string in that kind of range, or if you're playing that B flat on the 11th fret of your B string, it's gonna sound a little muddy as soon as you start getting down in that kind of area, that neighborhood. So the real comparison today is the difference between playing chords on a 4-string bass, standard tuning, and a 5-string bass with a high C. Of course, I'm a huge advocate for that high C, especially with chordal playing. It's a big part of what I do with my music. It's how I write a lot of my music. And if anyone's on the fence out there about, hey, should I try that out? I always recommend it. Just give it a go. I'm really glad I did some 20 or more years ago. And I think it's pretty easy to hear the difference in clarity of those inner moving parts when you're playing up in that register, as opposed to slightly darker down there. And that's not to say that all of these things that are in the book, that are in Chordal Harmony Volume 2, aren't possible on a 4-string. In fact, in the book, I was really careful this time to go into detail about 5-string low B, 5-string high C, and standard 4-string tuning. So there was something in there for everyone, no matter how you have your bass tuned. I just want to highlight, as you've been hearing so far, that there is a real difference when you get to that higher, that extended range, and that higher register for playing these parts. Now let's get down to exactly what this exercise is. Exercise one is on page 24. It's exercise one of the chord melody section for anyone who already has the book and wants to follow along. I'm basically taking an augmented triad, augmented spread triad, I should say, and let me explain a spread triad. Spread triad is when you take a regular triad, which is stacked with the root, the third, and the fifth, in order, in sequence, you basically take the middle note of your voicing and you put that up an octave. So this is a B-flat triad. And this is a B-flat spread triad, where we've taken this major third in the middle of the voicing and put it up an octave. So standard triad, spread triad. Now, the first chord of this exercise is an augmented spread triad. So augmented just simply means the sharp five. So I have a B-flat, an F-sharp, and a D natural, the 10th on top. And my inner moving part on every one of the major seven chords is moving from the sharp five to the major seven. So in the key of B flat, that's F sharp to A natural, the sharp five to the natural seven, while surrounded by the root and the 10th on top, root and major 10th on top. So So that's the inner moving part on the first chord. Then we drop down a half step. And this is what starts out as a very kind of standard looking minor seven voicing with A, G, and C natural on top. I'm sure you've seen that voicing before on bass for a minor seven. But the middle part is moving and that drops down a whole step from G natural to F natural, giving us another spread triad, this time an F spread triad in the first inversion, because it's basically F, it's an F triad, spread, and now in the first inversion, which means the major third is in the root. And that's the pattern all the way down. That's the exercise. It gets a little challenging down here. The stretch in the center of the voicing is obviously a lot bigger. Really gets that stretch in the fretting hand as the lower you get in the register. And for everyone with the five string, with the high C, you can take that upper fourth and start on E flat, exactly the same shapes, exactly the same voicing, exactly the same exercise, just upper fourth. Basically giving you two chord choices per melody note, hence the element of chord melody, hence the element of voice leading as the top voice leads down the instrument sequentially, and working on that inner moving part as well as the root motion. It's like a whole bunch of things rolled into one, and once you get it under your fingers, it's actually quite simple to talk about it and to explain it in English. Way more complicated than actually doing it. Analysis is often way more complicated than the actual performance of the idea. These strings are a little old, and again, not everybody's idea of old is very different. I know I'm on the extreme end of how often I change my strings, which is every two shows on the road or every 3 days when I'm home practicing. So I've actually just played four shows on these, which is very unusual for me. I normally change them every two, so they are feeling a little dead to me. So if you do have brighter strings, the standard four string tuning version of this exercise might ring out a little brighter. But right now, as I go up to the five string high C extended range area, singing out pretty well to my ear. And look at how much extra you get. You get that extra fourth. So all of these chords, until you get to here, until you get to that area of the neck, are the extended range. That's what you get above and beyond your standard four string. And that's really what I want to highlight with this video. The main difference between the two and what the other might afford you, especially when you get into much broader voicings and voicings with like half step crunches in the middle. Those tend to sing out a little more to my ear on the five string with the high C. I covered a lot of those in the book. I go over voicings for four string, five string high C, five string low B, and some of my favorite voicings for each of those tunings of the instrument. But listen to how clear that is, despite the fact I've got this real half step crunch right in the center of the voicing. And how I can keep that three note voicing on the top and move around the root motion from the four to the five to the one, if I think of it in terms of F minor. So again, a lot of those kind of things, reharmonization techniques, are included in the book, but I just want to highlight how much cleaner it is with those crunchier voicings in the high register of the instrument. And especially if you get into, like if we go a half step down so we can play some open strings, we can play open E there and get a real range difference and dynamic range from the open E to our top voicing. And if we pedal the E, kinds of amazing textures you can get and colors when you have that range. Again, that's not to say that isn't possible with a standard four string tuning. I can get a lot of those effects. They just get a little more muddy of those just then were standard four string tuning, not going above the 21st fret, that E natural on the G string. And it's again all about experimenting, whether you're high C, low B, standard four string tuning. It's about experimenting with how different your instrument is, how different your touch is, what you have to adjust as a bass player with your touch. And that's up to you to develop on your own instrument. I think that's a hugely important and often overlooked element of what it is to produce a great sound or produce ideas on the instrument. Really gotta experiment, work on your own sound, work on your own instrument, and trial and error, figure out exactly what it is you have to do to get the most out of it and to get the most beautiful sound out of ideas like this. So coffee drinkers, so psyched. Chordal Harmony Volume 2, links are below. Don't forget, the digital video is over 2 hours of video instruction this time around. I went totally crazy. I was shooting for 9 hours and then edited it all down. And so coffee drinkers, thank you for sticking around. I hope you dig the new book, Chordal Harmony Volume 2, Voicings, Chord Melody, and Reharmonization. Don't forget, digital video is over 2 hours long. All the links are below. For physical books at Amazon, for the digital bundle at my website. I'm bundling Chordal Harmony Volume 1, which is this guy right here, and Volume 2 together. If you don't have either book yet, you can get a huge discount if you buy both of them together. Always, thank you for being around. Thank you for checking this stuff out. Thank you for all the feedback while the process was going on with writing this. That was really important, to reach out to people, ask those questions on Instagram, get feedback about what you wanted to see in the book. And I was able to come up with 40 brand new exercises to populate that with. I hope that ends up in your practice routine. Hope it ends up inspiring you. And I will see you again very soon on the next video.